And we're back with Vinyl Reviews Episode 5, and this time it's featuring Kaan, K-A-A-N, Uncommon Knowledge, and K-A-N, of course, stands for Knowledge Above All Nonsense, and it's pronounced Kaan. Not the first time a lot of people probably heard of this artist, but the album is new, 2016, debut release on Redef Records, and the whole thing, top to bottom, it looks like has been produced by K-Def. Yeah, man, you can't ignore K-Def's contribution to, let me turn this down. Now, if you heard the beginning of that, you could hear a little something that sounded a little bit like what I refer to as Lil Wayne syndrome, you know, where you, the froggy shit, you know. So this guy, young, definitely schooled himself, not just in old school hip hop, but everything through the 90s. You know, you can hear in the references on his record, and you can hear in the styles that he's using when he's spitting, and the beats that he's chosen to rap to by K-Def, that this guy is a revitalist. He's somebody who's taken some of the foundations of hip hop and the things that we really loved back in the 90s and bringing that back to the forefront of his flow and his style and his approach to making music, which I think is fantastic. This is coming straight out of Maryland. And as far as I can see here on the internet, he's a 25-year-old kid, man, and he's definitely spitting flows on here that are reminiscent of early to late 90s. And the production choices, all by K-Def, top to bottom. And if you don't know who K-Def is, man, I mean, right off the top, we got to talk about Chief Rocker, you know what I mean, 93. But we can also talk about, you know, what he's done for Ghostface, Theodore Unit, I think Puff Daddy, I believe Jay, I could be wrong there. UGK, you know, there's a lot of little random artists there that he's produced for that have been dope and you know, over the years, but he's a 90s producer. It's a short album, it's less than 20 minutes long, and out of the 9 tracks on here, 1, 2, 3 of them are interludes and one of them is an intro. So 4 of them out of the 5 are pieces of sampled music or looped music by K-Def, and the rest is spit from my man Kaan. Something you got to appreciate about this guy, though, is that by the time he was born in 1991, some of the best hip-hop that was ever made had already been made and released, you know? So this guy was born after the entire golden era ended, you know? So anything that he heard, he wasn't here in 92 or 93. He was a fucking baby, man. So by the time the kid was even conscious of really having taste in hip-hop, he was already 8, 9, 10 years old minimum, right? So that puts him at 2000, 2001 when he first started having exposure to hip-hop that was meaningful. So that tells me that he's developed his taste and his skills over the last 10 or 15 years. And to me, that's impressive when you're coming up with a project like this that is so sample heavy. On the first track, Music, the first time I've heard Marvin Gaye's music flipped since Eric Sermon did it. And it's dope. Great drums. He's rhyming fast over the whole thing. We're talking crawling intensity. You know, he starts off a little calmer, and then he builds up that energy, and you really, really hear this kid show off his lyrical prowess. And when I say prowess, I mean this. We're talking he's on that level of anybody in the golden age that was doing bullet spits, or anybody that was doing, you know, he's out fushnicking the fushnickins, and that's fine because he's had 15, 20 years to study. But at the same time, man, he's doing those 90s styles, and he's doing them as good or better than the pros from that era. And I think that's important to recognize. First track, Music. Kaan says, I want that music real so I can feel it for sure. I realize that they don't even make that shit anymore. And then he repeats it. I mean, so he gets it. He understands the timeline of hip-hop and how things were in the late 80s, 90s, mid-90s, late 90s, and then 2000s. You know, he's looked back and he's done his research, and I'm not just he downloaded some MP3 files. You can tell this kid, this man is like, I'm sorry, man, when you're old, you call people kids. You can tell this guy has literally steeped in 90s hip-hop. I mean, it's not something that he's got a passing familiarity with or looked up some Wikipedia searches. This guy is marinated in 90s hip-hop, and that's a real good thing because he's taken some of the styles that you'll hear in 2015, 2016, 2017, and he's applying some of what we're hearing on the radio now, but he's grinding it up and he's bringing it back down to the foundational aesthetics of hip-hop music. The production says it all. I mean, there's not a whack beat on the EP, and some of the interludes is just damn good as the songs. We're talking samples that I've never heard before, and I've heard fucking everything, not just Nautilus, you know? And the samples that he does reuse, K-Def, those things are done inventively, and they're done in a way where I can enjoy them again. Like the Eric Sermon sample of Marvin Gaye's Music files, right? You know, that was fantastic. But now the K-Def has revamped it, you know, so many years later, and he's done it in a sped-up beat. It sounds just as fresh. A lot of people throw that word knowledge around, you know, because they don't have that word in the context of late 80s, early 90s hip-hop, when we know that knowledge meant having knowledge itself. And that there's a whole expansive world that's behind that phrase, right? So he's saying things like, you know, he's calling himself knowledge above all nonsense, which I believe, in a sense, you know, he's hitting the mark there, because he has knowledge of this 90s, 80s hip-hop, and he's bringing that knowledge to the forefront in his own expressions above all the nonsense that you're hearing now usually, right? So I can respect that. He's also saying lines on here like, only God can save us. And with all due respect, what God is he talking about? You know, I can't recommend this as a purchase highly enough. I think that any hip-hop connoisseur that loves 80s and 90s and contemporary hip-hop, there's something here for everybody. If you're somebody like the record that I dislike, that Kendrick Lamar record, that unreleased, unmastered, you might like this, because it's not just 80s and 90s hip-hop. The speed with which this guy's building his bars also, and the vocal tonalities also borrow from a little bit more of that high-pitched flavor that you're hearing and a lot of people are so welcoming of nowadays, that I don't tend to like. But it wasn't enough to offend me and dislike this project. In general, I love it, and I'm going to be playing it again and again in rotation, because it's one of those cases where somebody in the contemporary era actually did his homework and got with producers and got with other people and got ears. I could tell he got the ears lended to some OGs and older heads that were really, really into hip-hop back in the day, and he got their opinions. Because here, it sounds like he's trying to impress people that know hip-hop music inside and out. From the references he's making, from Tribe to a number of other hip-hop artists from back in the day, to the way in which he's expressing himself, which is definitely in line with everything I love about hip-hop. This is definitely an artist from Maryland I would recommend. I actually got the artist from a West Coast head, which is surprising to me. I really love hearing new music, guys. I returned that Kendrick Lamar for $6, and I got the new Master Ace joint, which I can't wait to finish listening to and review. Send me your records, lovblog@gmail.com, and you'll get a review also. Peace, y'all. Keep buying records.